In my opinion, genomics is better as it can provide many minute details of mutations in various clinical conditions.
In my opinion, proteomics is better since it provides us valuable information about proteins, which are very dynamic biomolecules, thereby revealing targets of therapeutic value.
How about we make best use of both genomics and proteomics technology and try to integrate that information to obtain some novel insights?
Proteogenomics is an emerging and collaborative arena of research at the interface of proteomics and genomics.
The beauty of proteogenomics is that it offers the ability to provide a more comprehensive picture of the underlying biology of cancer. And I think that that was already unequivocally demonstrated by the National Cancer Institute CPTAC program, where they actually demonstrated the ability when you combine proteomics comprehensively above a comprehensive layer of genomics, both in colorectal cancer, breast cancer, and ovarian cancer, you're able to pull out additional biology that is either difficult to obtain or simply not feasible.
You know, we still have only sequenced a small percentage of the total organisms that are on the world. So there's a lot more we could do, but we're limited with that.
Adding in the proteomics, what we can do is use the proteomics to prioritize which of the genomic changes are actually important.
To me, I think a better way is to integrate all these technologies. I mean, we want to gain a holistic view of the system, and the way to do that is by analyzing the system at different molecular levels, if you can.
Artificial intelligence and machine learning and all those areas, the buzzwords that you hear are becoming actually more and more useful in doing analysis.
Advanced genomics and proteomics technologies and the data from high-quality human biospecimens may identify potentially actionable therapeutic molecular targets.
ICPC, the beauty of that, I think that's one of the initiatives that was inspired by the United States Cancer Moonshot effort. Today, it's an incredible program. Currently, it involves 12 countries. That spans over 31 institutions. Collectively, all these institutions in these countries are now working together to try to better understand over a dozen cancer types at the molecular level. I think the part that also makes it extra special is that each one of these institutions in these countries have pledged of the molecular data that they generate, they're gonna make it available to the public. So for me, the idea of ICPC, the goal, the ultimate goal, is actually quite simple. And that is ultimately to develop an international database that's now is gonna be representative of the diversity of people along with their cancer.